Hello students, welcome to the class. I am Yogita. Our subject is psychology. Psychology for nurses. And today's topic is need. Now, we can see that people behave in different ways, in different situation. Now, it doesn't mean that a psychology always tell us what people behave. And also, it's equally important to make us to understand how they people behave. Now, these people may behave in a different situation, in different way. Now, that can be easily understood with the terms called motivation. Now, a certain need make you to motivated towards to reach your goal. So, today, we are going to study about that need. Now, what is need? When individual is wanted something, they had a desire to achieve something, that particular thing is known as need. Now, individuals have a certain ideas in their mind, or they want certain things to exist, to live. That will be a need of an individual. Now, basically, this need will be classified in two types: biological need and a psychological need. Biological and psychological. Now, let us see what is this biological need. Now, these biological needs are also known as primary needs. These needs are very, very essential for the survival. For example, now see, I need oxygen to survive. In case if there is a lack of oxygen, deprivation from oxygen, I may die. No, definitely I will die. So, this is what called a need which is really, really important for the existence of an individual. So, such needs are called as biological needs. Now, these needs are also called as physiological need. So, basic biological need or else primary needs or physiological needs. Now, what are the biological needs? Need for oxygen. Definitely, as how I said, oxygen is really, really essential. When there is lack of oxygen, difficulty to exist. Need for food. Definitely, we need food for a survival. If it is deprived from food for many days, it is quite difficulty to exist. Chances that they may die. Need for water. Definitely, water is really, really essential to live. So, we drink a lot of water from morning to evening. We don't have a count. We may drink, if anyone is taking less amount of water, definitely they develop with certain physical complaints. They may find difficulty in passing urine. They may feel indigestion. See, there are a lot of physical complaints that is related with your drinking amount of water. So, water is a basic need. Need for rest and sleep. Definitely, individual want the good kind of rest and sleep. So, we suggest the normal individual take 6 to 7 hours of sleep per day. So, this sleep will provide you complete rest as well as it will re-energize you. So, you will get a re-energy once you had a good sleep and wake up. Need for temperature. It's a good environment that when the individual can function in a better way, when the temperature is 37 degrees Celsius. So, we expect a good level of temperature for the survival. Then, need of a shelter, that also required because to have this basic food, oxygen, water, then definitely this is one of your basic needs to have a shelter so that you can protect yourself in that house from all kind of external threats, maybe like extreme cold, hot, rainy season or any kind of criminals, anything you can protect yourself. So this is called your biological need. So, need of rest. Need of sex. It's not very essential to survive. Like, we can't say that without sex we cannot survive. But definitely we survive. But for a good domestic life, it's one of the part of life. So, these what we discussed all are the biological needs, which is really essential. Like, need for oxygen, need for food, need for water, need for rest and sleep, need for temperature, need for sex. Now, next category is psychological need. Now, it's almost related to your mentality and your mindset. It's for your recreation, for your relaxation. Now, this is also related to your socio-cultural life, your relationship with your others, the way how you deal with your family, friends, these all things will matter now. Now, psychological needs are also called as secondary needs or else learned needs, where you are learning how to live. Got it? Like where you are learning how to behave in a society. For here, a very important like love and affection. See, need of love and affection. Every individual want to be loved and they want someone to love. So they want that affectionate feelings. They want that living together. They want someone to be with them to share their emotional feelings. They want emotional attachment. The need of security. See, definitely when you live in a society, you want a security. You want feel comfortable. You are safe. So, like maybe husband and wife, they feel secure each other. When the small kids feel secure when they're with the parents. And elderly people, they feel secure when they're with the children or in their family members. So, this is a need of security. Then they have a need of freedom, need of achievement, need of social company, need of power. See, every individual expects something. They want some psychological aspect made them to feel happy. Definitely a need of power. Everyone have a desire to control others and have a dominant, rule others. It is depending on each individual personality, what kind of mentality they have. They have a need of freedom, like they want to do something what they want so that they'll get a relaxation, they get recreation, they feel happy, they feel some, this can spend some qualitative of time of their life. As well as need of social company, like making friendship, a relationship with your neighbors. You are having a very good relationship with your co-workers. See, this is very, very essential. When there is no good relationship, you may find it very difficult to live in your society. You don't have that mutual understanding, communication, no helping each other. See, that leads to other problem. So that's the reason here everyone have that desire to have that good social company. Then definitely you need like having good social cultural relationship. You are having like a peace of mind in your life and need to have good economically stable. You want a need that you will be like your religious beliefs that will give you a pleasure. So all these needs are essential for life. Sometime even if it is doesn't present, we will exit. It doesn't mean that if there is no, if there is no power, if you don't have any authority, you will die. No, it's not like that. But thing is that whenever you meet that need, that will motivate you. That will help you to do something best. That will help you to achieve your goal. So this is the basic two types of needs. So you have to explain it, write all these things. Biological need and biological need is also called as primary need, physiological need, or unlearned needs. You no need to teach someone to do that. You no need to train someone how to breathe and take oxygen. So immediately they will do. When you feel hunger, that need of food, when you feel hungry, you will really try to find some food. When you feel need of water, when you feel thirsty, definitely you will go and drink a glass of water. See, no one need to teach you. So that is what called a biological need. Now, secondary needs are also known as psychological needs. It also learned needs, where you need to learn how to behave in a society, how to give respect to others, how to deal with others so that you have a very good relationship, mutual understanding, love, affection, care, safety, social company, power, authority, everything. So I hope you understood. This is all about need. Please keep watching. We can study a little more about motivation. And I'll see you in next class with a new concept. Until then, take care of yourself. Thank you all.